Good morning, my dear students. In the previous class, I have sent you 5 important questions. Among these 5 important questions, I have already explained 3 important questions. Means what is kinesis, what is proximacy, and what is encoding. Today I am going to explain the rest 2 important questions and some other questions also. The first question, the third question was, which I have already sent to you, what is two-way communication? Two-way communication occurs when the receiver sends response of feedback to sender's message. In two-way communication process, the sender first transmits the message to the receiver. After receiving a message, the receiver decodes it and sends back its other reaction to the sender. So, if you simplify this answer, that means two-way communication is just like a two-way traffic. In this communication, both the sender and the receiver remain active. The sender sends the message, the receiver receives it, and when the receiver gives his feedback and response on the message of sender, that is called feedback, and it is called a two-way communication. In two-way communication, both the sender and the receiver take active role. And where if we give a glance to one-way communication, in one-way communication only the sender is active, but in two-way communication both the sender and the receiver are active. So it is very fruitful for communication, for communication, that means two-way communication is very fruitful than the one-way communication. For example, classroom teaching is an burning example of two-way communication, where the students and the teachers play important role, right? Then I am going to explaining, define semantic noise. Semantic noise is a communication is a type of disturbance in the transmission of a message that interferes with the interpretation of message due to ambiguity in words, sentences, or symbols used in transmission of the message. So, semantic noise means when you transfer our message from one person to another, sometimes it is hampered, it is disturbed by some unwanted things, by some ambiguity, by some other hindrances. These obstacles are called semantic noise, and when semantic noise occurs, it will create a little bit misunderstanding in the minds of the receiver. That means the receiver does not get the sender's message properly because of this noise. So due to noise, the communication process will be a failure one. So, in order to avoid such type of barriers, means such type of noise, we have to careful about it, and we should be take some necessary steps to avoid such type of noise. The next question, I have already sent that next question. That one was, That one was what is feedback in communication? What is feedback in communication? Feedback is a process, or feedback means the receiver's response is called feedback. When the sender sends the message, the receiver receives it and gives his response, that is called feedback, which is very essential in a communication process. Because of feedback, a communication process will be an effective one. Without feedback, a communication process will not be effective. So feedback plays an important role in communication process. Actually, it is the amount of response of the receiver that reaches to the sender. It enables the sender to evaluate the effectiveness of the message. So, in order to measure the effectiveness of the sender's message, feedback is highly essential. So, the next question is, what is interpersonal communication? Interpersonal communication is the process by which people exchange information, feelings and meanings through verbal and non-verbal messages. It is a face-to-face communication. It is not recorded by anywhere. There are four main types of interpersonal communication we use on a daily basis. They are verbal, non-verbal, written and visual. So, interpersonal communication is called a private communication where nothing is recorded. It may be verbal, non-verbal, written or visual. It has no certain rules and regulations. So, that's why it is called a face-to-face communication. And it is a process by which people exchange information, feelings and meanings through verbally or non-verbally without any fear, because it has no certain rules and regulations. This is called interpersonal communication. Then I am going to explaining, define decoding in communication. Decoding is a process of interpretation and transmission of coded information into message. That means when you change the symbol into a message, that is called decoding. That means when you change the message into a symbol form, that is called decoding. It is a process of turning of communication into thoughts. Means from thoughts we can change into symbols. So this is all about the questions that I have sent you. Please read it mindfully. If you have any doubts, then ask me. Thank you.